Piccolo? There's something I wanted to talk to you about.
Sure, yeah. But why are you still a Super Saiyan?
Huh? I don't really know how to explain why, but I'm trying to continue my training.
You still feel responsible for your dad's death, huh?
Yeah, that's part of it. I need to make sure I'm strong enough to protect the Earth now. That's why I'm still a Super Saiyan. I want my body to get used to this form a bit more.
I see. So it looks like I didn't need to worry after all.
Huh?
Since Frieza showed up, even after we believed he was dead, I always thought I had to be on my guard. But if Cell or some new android show up, you're the only one that has what it takes to beat them. So I planned on giving you a push in the right direction when you needed it. But I guess you really didn't need me to do that.
Oh, so that's what you mean. It makes me happy to hear you have so much faith in me.
So, you got a more concrete training regimen planned? Just being a Super Saiyan isn't going to cut it, you know.
Yeah, it's just... I still don't know what else I can do.
I guess that's understandable. You pretty much did all you could do in the hyperbolic time chamber.
Do you have any ideas?
With regards to your strength, you're probably as strong as you can get right now, so you won't see much rapid improvement in terms of raw power. What you lack is mental fortitude.
Mental fortitude?
Your dad, he knows how to remain focused in battle. You, on the other hand, you're still too emotional.
You might be right about that. If I had focused more, I could have prevented Cell from self-destructing. So, what should I do?
You might not like this suggestion, but why don't you try training with Vegeta? He's the strictest guy around when it comes to emotion. And not just with others, but with himself too. He might be able to provide some insight into the mental aspects of combat.
Understood. I'll go ask Vegeta if he can help me out.
If you can get Vegeta to train you, you'll probably get where you want to be.
I bet this tastes really good! I think I can take this guy. Yep. I'm going to do this! Your dad's counting on me!
Yeah!
books when I get back. There's a lot of energy in this thing.
How's that sound?
I pretty much have, yeah. Only thing I really need to do is, I just need to farm on it in a way. It's the only thing I really need to do. Because I was gonna, literally, because obviously,
I think I can take this guy.
I pretty much stream this, and then whenever,
going to
obviously,
do
I,
this.
Come on,
that's counting on me.
I'm going secure for a bit to do some more farming, but. I could have got a lot of progress done, but literally, since I stopped streaming, I just started watching something, and then I started making a fucking deck. Card game. Oh, yeah, fine. Then when I looked at the time, I was fucking out, it's 9 o'clock, and I was like, wow. Yeah, I am. Yeah, I've got pretty much just one sword up here. Just don't sell sword right now, I'm on. Well, it's technically not the boo saga yet.
I hope this brings me closer to my dad.
But to be fair, this is actually, if you play it how I'm playing it, it is actually pretty, it is pretty long.
I think I can take this guy.
Yeah.
You're up against me now!
Because they have missed out a lot of quite a few things on the game. Kind of makes sense on why they're fucking doing it. Because, one, like I say, it's a pretty big fucking game, and if you had to catch shit in, it'd be like even fucking longer. But it's the type of person that likes to, like, get all the characters on RPGs, get all the characters maxed out and shit. For a while. It's not an achievement, no.
Better hit the books when I get back.
Play the game. I'm just playing it. Enjoying it. Because now I could easily just go straight to the mission that I need to do, but every time the Dragon Balls appear, again, I'll collect them. So obviously I can just make a wish.
I think I can take this guy.
Well, it's only,
going to do this.
Get a bunch of money, get a bunch of orbs. Revive people, like people that you've burst, so you can actually fight them again, and then when you beat them, you unlock their emblem, so you can obviously point in your skill tree. No, I'm actually kind of, I don't like feel it like that, to be fair. This feels like a Dragon Ball Z game with like RPG elements in it. But it is, like I said though, it is a game that if you're a big Dragon Ball Z fan, then this is like a must. Because the only thing I started doing whenever I got the wishes or the Dragon Balls, I just wished for some more, for fucking loads of orbs, as you can see, there's like fucking loads of the bastards. But there's a wish that I can wish for like rare items, and I should have been doing that, because then it allows me to do me like main skill trees up a little bit faster to gain more abilities. So like when I says when you can revive people, like I revived Nappa, it allowed me to fight him, and then when I beat him I unlocked his emblem to put in my main skill tree, like I said. Wish for a lot of money, and then that's pretty much it. They're the main three options that you get. Or you
there's a lot of energy in this thing.
And obviously that's to mainly put... It's mainly to put in your skill trees, that's all it is for, to max them out. But because it does kind of feel like, since I've played this, it feels like I don't need to play, because I've been contemplating again, Exoverse, Xenoverse, whatever it is. I feel like the game, the way that game plays is going to pretty much, I'm playing it now in a way, but I'm just playing a longer game in a way. Plus on that, you get to create your own character and shit and customize them and stuff. But it does feel like since I've been playing this, it's like if I went to that, I'll think, oh, fuck no. It is kind of the same, but...
I think I can take this guy.
Like I said, if you think about it, where it's obviously sections of the game, if you actually put this in one full fucking game... Plus, you've got to fly there, walk there yourself.
This thing looks super tasty! Wow!
It would take a fucking
long time. This apple looks delicious! Oh, this is a keeper.
Because there's even some bits when I've been playing, it's like recently, it's when Gohan goes Super Saiyan 2 for the first time. when 16's talking to him, he's like talking to him like they've spoke about it before, and obviously you never get to see that. And literally on this game before it, there's like a side mission that you can do with Android 16, and it actually kind of it shows you and tells you what they were talking about when it tells him to let go and shit for when he fights South. Because even Android 16 says, he says, you've got the power to beat Cell. You've got it within you. Just, you've just got to unleash it in a way. I'm thinking that's actually kind of sick. Because it's been going around for ages. How the fuck did... Because like the main one, Android 16 got fixed. But you never see it in the cartoon. You never see him get fixed. And there's another... That's literally the side quest. He gets sent to Bulma and then Bulma fixes him. And then it obviously shows you and tells you how they actually knew each other and stuff. They actually helped each other out. And then that's when they liked each other. And then that's when obviously fucking thingy pops. I don't know why as well, but
I think I can take this guy.
This it gives me a lot of... It feels like Budokai as well. Obviously, Budokai is obviously a fighter.
I think I can take this guy. There's a lot of energy in going.
They also did
deal
with this.
Dad's counting on me.
There was a SNES game, Dragon Ball Z SNES game. For some reason, it kind of reminds me of that, but it's nothing alike. Even the main cutscenes of the game are fucking fantastic. Fuck's sake, game, let me fucking play.
Closer to my dad.
I can't imagine how much shit you're gonna be doing when you're fucking level 100. That's it, damage. Fucking hell. Because it's one of those type of
stone.
RPGs where.
Look at the shine on this. It's gotta
if you're
be
literally
rare.
Like two levels off, you're not fucking doing shit towards that other enemy. No fucking chance. So I tried it. There's like these secret fights, and they're like. Buffed up enemies. It's like one
I
killed
I take this guy.
Raditz, Nappa, Vegeta together, and then Frieza spawned, and he's level 65. And I went for him fighting. Literally, every time I was hitting him, I was doing one damage, and then he literally hit me and bat fucking killed me. But they have put a like, they've put a lot of time in like with type of shit that is on the game. Like unlocking forms and stuff. And these little things that they've added in that kind of pushes it together with certain things that you think, ah, the fuck. Because there's been these loads like that on the original cartoon when like something like happened and it goes, hold on, how did he know this? How did he do that? How did he become like this type shit? And there is a lot of things that I actually tell you. Which is obviously, like I said, it's this game. If you're a big fucking Dragon Ball Z fan, it's a fucking must, 100%. And it's one of those games. It's enjoyable when you're playing. It's enjoyable, especially if you like complete like doing everything. Then this game, like I said, it will take you a very fucking long time. Which I'll show you. You can obviously start watching with these community things, and plus you can play as these characters as well. Well, some of them. You can play as some of them. And pretty much every single character, you can get them to level 100. And you've got to... You can rank up their abilities as well. They've all got different, like, skill trees to go towards different things. So you can level all them up, and obviously every single one that you get, you can level them up. And there's 4 pages of all of it. And then, because I was even thinking about what could they do for DLC since there's a season pass. The only thing I can really think of is that if they bring Dragon Ball Super into it, or they bring some of the movies. It's the only thing I can really think of.
It's cold in here!
Sound more like the movies then. Because to me, movies seem more of a, like, it seems more reasonable because it's Dragon Ball, they're actual Dragon Ball Z movies. Because the one thing that I fucking like, the one thing you get to see, you even get to talk to her, sometimes you even see when I'm fucking flying about, Android 21. And she wasn't on the original cartoon, she was only on Dragon Ball Fighters. And obviously Dragon Ball Fighters is not canon, and it is set after Super, but it's not canon. But they clearly stated on this is actually, it's the you're playing the entire fucking cartoon from Dragon Ball Z, from fucking the Saiyan Saga all the way up to Buu Saga. And it kind of tells me that they originally wanted to put Android 21 in, but they just didn't do that. Because you even find out the name, because Android 16 is the image of Android 21's son in Android 20. Because obviously Android 20 and Android 21 had a kid. In Android 16, they built him after his image. And you actually find out what his name was as well. And we've not known that for fucking years.
Is that a village? Let's check it out!
So it kind of thinks that they originally wanted to make 21 canon, but obviously they didn't. Oh, she's here. I can't get 21.
Looks delicious! This thing looks super tasty! I bet this tastes really good!
Right up.
Pardon me. Right, last Dragon Ball. I've seen that. They've supposedly brought out another Neo 2 trailer. I have not seen. Can't wait. It's gonna be good. I've also heard that, seen there's supposedly like a game-breaking bug on, well, it's not game-breaking, well, it technically is game-breaking, for COD, the latest patch. Well, and plus I've just clicked on it, that don't really fucking matter anyway.
I think I can take
really
this guy.
There's no such thing as prestige in anyway. Anyway. because I'd noticed as well, because when I came into things, it's got these missions in. I'm thinking, hold on, how the fuck do I get these? But I thought, oh, you probably need to wish them. Pardon me.
One wish, anything that is within my power. State your wish.
Set fucking 9, mate, for card game. It's a big fucking game changer. Fucking shit that's coming. Fucking game changer, mate. It feels like with this set, if you've got the right cards, if you've got the cards to make a deck within these certain cards, it's like if you come up against any other fucking deck that hasn't got these cards in, it's like you've got the fucking megast advantage. Like, it's going to feel one-sided in a way. If you've not got the cards, it's like you've got to be lucky that they don't get them in their hands. Especially that fucking freezer card. Fucking stupid.
I think I can take this guy. You're up against me now. When I get back. I bet it's cooler around the oasis. This thing's filled with power. I could see an oasis from here.
Hey! Huh? Hey! Yeah!
Yes! Why?
Huh? Hey!
Yes!
Whoa!
No!
Hehehe! Indeed.
Hey.
Yeah.
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 What?
That's enough!
You jerk!
Wait a sec!
Hey!
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 Hi!
Yeah!
Hey! You got it, mate!
Indeed.
Hey.
Yeah.
Yeah. Huh?
Hey, that's a pretty nifty haircut you got there.
I was constructed with this hair.
Thank you.
that stops them. All right, better find Vegeta so I can ask for his help.
What do you want?
Would you mind fighting me so I can get stronger? My dad died because of me. I need to get stronger so something like that doesn't happen again. It's up to me to maintain peace now. I need to protect Earth in my dad's place.
Don't be absurd. You think Kakarot's dead because of you? You're the one that's going to replace him? You arrogant, spoiled little brat!
Huh?
Damn it. I wasn't planning on fighting ever again, but I've changed my mind now. Come at me. I'll beat the arrogance out of you.
Tastes really good.
I'm going to see if you have what it takes to fill in for Kakarot. If this scares you, then you're nothing.
Okay.
Than this!
I'm not done yet!
You were far more powerful than this when you defeated Cell. You were holding back, weren't you?
No, that's not true.
A soft, spineless brat like you could never replace Kakarot. Stupid child.
Yeah, Vegeta's right. I can't define who I am based on who my dad was. I need to do some serious soul searching. I'd better stay a Super Saiyan a little longer. Mom's not gonna be happy about it, though.
Greetings. Thank you so much. Greetings. Yes. Let's see. What do you think? Thank you so much.
Right.
Excuse me.
What?
Oh, shit.
Hey.
Huh?
Yes.
Hey.
Let's see. What?
Sure.
Right.
Yes.
How is that sound?
What?
Oh, ho, ho. You!
Hi!
Very well.
What?
Indeed.
Right! this guy. I think I can take this guy. There's a sunken ship! I got it! All right! I found a rare fish!
Thank you so much!
What? Right!